Добрый день. In the previous video, we've looked at how to make nouns plural. So we were saying that you add u ending to most nouns, and if you have the word student, you want to make it plural, studenti, telefon, telefone. So this time we're going to look at adjectives, the describing words, прилагательное, множественное число. If you haven't noticed, even the videos recorded on nouns are based on this exercise, exercise 510 in your textbook on page 69. So I'm using the examples to help you understand things and also to help you with the exercise at the same time. So these are the rules we've discussed. They refer to nouns, words that refer to people, places, and things. We were saying ia nouns are going to change to ee at the end. The soft sign changes to e, I changes to e. And then if we have any of these seven letters, the seven letter spelling rule applies when we have to add e. Otherwise, we add u to masculine and feminine nouns. If we have a neuter noun, then neuter nouns end in o or ye. So if the neuter noun ends in o, change it to a. If the neuter noun ends in ye, change it to ya. This time we're looking at adjectives. So if your noun comes with a describing word, you have to change the number of that adjective as well, because the describing word always agrees with the noun it describes in number, gender, case, everything. So this is your rule for adjectives, and I think it's much easier than for nouns actually, because adjectives have two letter endings, so the plural form of adjectives is uya. And it doesn't matter whether your adjective, your singular adjective, was masculine, feminine, or neuter. It does not matter. Uya will be used with all of them, so that makes it easier. So the only exception is that the same seven letter spelling rule applies to adjectives as well. And if you're trying to add uya to the stem, to the everything in the word except for the ending, if you're trying to add uya to the stem that ends in one of these seven letters, you can't really add u. So this u cannot be next to any of these letters. That means we're going to add e, and then you still need ye, because adjectives have two letter endings. So instead of uye, ie will be used if the stem ends in one of those letters. So here is our first example. Let's say I have Ruskiy zhurnal, a Russian magazine, Russian journal, as the phrase that I'm trying to make plural. Let's say I have more than one Russian magazine. So let's start with the noun first, and with the nouns we check for the seven letter spelling rule. Does not really apply because the ending is L, so we're adding uy. Журналы. Now, русский is an adjective. The last two letters are will form the ending, and those are the ones we need to drop and replace with our ending for adjectives uye. But once we do that, can't do that. So here we have ka right next to u, and as you remember, they don't talk. So here is ka, one of those seven letters that is not friends with u. It says, okay, I'm okay with e, but don't put me next to u. So stuck with e instead of u because of that ka. So the phrase in plural will be русские журналы. So русский журнал will be Russian magazine, singular. Русские журналы will be plural, Russian magazines. And as you see, in Russian, you have to change both words. Not just the noun becomes plural, but the adjective becomes plural with it. So I'm going to stop here, give you my examples and the summary in the next video. До свидания.